But the Insurance Act was changed in 2006 or 2005 to actually accommodate annuities as a special form of policy. So don't be misled by anybody. The Insurance Act was crafted in a way that it said these policies fell under its provisions. And that's why we are seeking recovery. Don't be misled by anybody at all, please. Okay? Case law currently being created in Trinidad, in Antigua. There is case law in Canada, and of course there is case law in the former colonial power, the UK, which has prevalence and has direct application in situations like this, as to what a government can do where insolvency, where the regulatory mechanisms have failed. And they're all pertinent. So please, don't think that there is nothing that we can draw a comparison with this country.
I think it's like $20 easy to do. $20 is really $16.67 per month. Less than $20, less than a snap box. Less than a roti, probably a big chain. Or close to that. I mean, realistically speaking, if you look at spending those little small amounts on water, even gas, gas is so pricey today. $20 a day, you buy $10 or more. And if you're complaining about $200 a year for an attorney representation, for website, for membership, for all the other things that comes with it, come on, you really seriously have to rethink again. The average attorney alone to go to a divorce settlement, $3,000, $5,000, $10,000, $12,000. A real estate property, 10% on average of the sale value of the property. So that can run between $50,000 to maybe $100,000 in fees alone. And you got to pay these amounts out of your pocket easily. If you as an individual were to go and seek counsel alone on this same matter, you're probably going to spend between $10,000, $15,000, $20,000 as an individual. And you're paying $20, less than $20 a month for representation. And you're also getting pro bono attorneys by Dr. Gabriel Phillips. And the other person, Peter, I think that's the last thing, sorry. Peter, my apologies.
Might be qualified accountant.
Right, a qualified accountant and attorneys. We must really be grateful and account of that. And with that, thank you.
We saw for the first time the Spirit of God, in my opinion, put into the attorneys on the other side. I can't go into details, but we saw, we can see where they really want to stop us. But this is just the beginning. If we get going, it's like a snowball on a mountain coming down. We're going to pick up momentum, we're going to gather some energy and some speed. But we can see where some submissions and so on and so forth. If they could block this first move, they would frustrate us. So we have got to start in court. So you need to stand behind us.
Is it possible that if an action like this goes through and we are successful, that those who are benefiting without joining this group can, in the legal decision, final decision, be made to pay a percentage of what they have there in all of New York? That is what is necessary. When things like this happen, and a few individuals take their few dollars and press a court action, we succeed. Those who benefit without compound should be made by law to pay a certain percentage of what they have there as part of the proceeding.
We've had this before. There's nothing we can do about it. Once we set a precedent, other people will benefit from that precedent, whether we like it or not. And this is where your courage comes in. And I know that it is very difficult to ignore that other people are sitting back there. But if it wasn't for you, we wouldn't be this far ahead. I don't know how to answer for those people. I think it's immoral, but there's nothing you can do about it.
I also listened to a video clip that was taken of the governor of the Central Bank in Trinidad and Tobago at a conference at the Hilton in Port of Spain. And he says that the CLICO downfall in Barbados and the Eastern Caribbean, the blame for that could be put squarely at the feet of government. Now, people in Trinidad are now being paid out 100% for their CLICO ESPAs. I know I have family involved. And what they have all received is $75,000 cash and a bond. The first bond is for 50% of their investment. Now, I'm not sure of the length of that bond, the term of that bond. However, if it is cashed in right away, what they will receive is the 50% of their investment minus the $75,000 cash payout they got, and they'll get 80% of the balance.
Yes.
There will be a second bond issue that nobody has got yet. Nobody knows the terms of that. But basically, the Trinidad government is paying out 100%. Maybe over a period of time, but they are doing 100%. How will that impact what happens in Barbados with our government? Will it have, you know, how the Barbados government and the Trinidad government are always sort of jockeying for who is the best?
In the interests of certainly the judicial managers, try and avoid coming to any conclusion and to allow the process to run. One of the press releases that June referred to was, has it been issued yet?
Yeah.
They're talking about 5 to 6 months before they identify investors. So, I mean, it gives you an idea that 5 to 6 months takes us almost to summer. There's going to be a summer recess. People will then be diverted over to Cropover. Once Cropover is finished, children go back to school, then suddenly Christmas is here, and there is a strategy here. I'm sorry, that, you know, I have a very cynical view of this, and that's why we need to run it as quickly as possible. Trinidad has one benefit, which is that it solved the problem early and actually made considerable investment into the statutory fund, which didn't happen here at all.